One of our strengths here at the University of Minnesota College of Veterinary Medicine is that we have a critical mass of faculty that are doing veterinary student teaching and applied research. And without that critical mass, we couldn't be nearly as effective in our missions of teaching, research, and outreach and extension to the dairy industry.
A lot of the diseases we're starting to deal with are chronic level diseases, so we need research at the basic level to say what are causes of diseases, what prevents it, how do we treat it, but we also need research to say how do we communicate that knowledge to the industry. Because I think to really motivate change, you have to be on the farm and work with these people.
We've been studying mastitis control for decades. However, it continues to be the most important and costly infectious disease in dairy cows. We've learned over the last many years that many of those infections aren't going to respond from antibiotic therapy. And so if we can do rapid on-farm diagnostics to find what is the cause of this mastitis case, we can cut drug use in half. So we can ensure the future health and production potential of the cow while reducing drug use by as much as 50% by using these rapid on-farm diagnostic techniques that were developed here at the University of Minnesota. In addition to just doing the research, one of our important missions is training graduate students. They will be the next generation of researchers and educators. We have a private-public partnership with a large dairy in South Central Minnesota.
We do a lot of our teaching at the Dairy Education Center, so we have access to a large dairy where a lot of our clinical teaching happens.
We provide students not just with the theoretical knowledge, the classroom didactic teaching that is traditional, but we also take them to the Dairy Education Center where we can move them out of the classroom, where we can actually see and do a number of the techniques that we talk about in the classroom.
We teach kind of the herd level approach, trying to get students to see, okay, you're a veterinarian and you treat individual animals, but we also say, how do you prevent disease? How do you take it to the herd level?
If we can find additional resources, financial support, we can continue to do research that continues to allow us to improve the health, the welfare of these animals that we all care so much about, as well as help the producers. The other concern that we're all looking out for is the quality and safety of the food that is produced. So with more resources, we can continue to design and conduct studies that address those concerns.